Hey everyone, welcome to Mia Prep's physics course. I'm your instructor, Dr. Morris, and in this lesson, we'll start to take a look at what physics is. You know, when I first started studying physics, I loved how every new topic told me something really cool about the world. How the world of the really small worked, like atoms or electrons. How the world of the really large scale worked, like galaxies and the universe as a whole. And it answered really deep questions like, does the universe have a beginning? In this lesson, we'll begin to take a look at just what physics is. And it's my hope that by the end of the course, you'll know and love physics like I do. Let's take a look. First, let's review our lesson objectives. We're going to start by defining physics. That way you know what it is we're studying. Then we'll discuss three important physics discoveries so you know what physics does. And lastly, we'll review our class structure and assignments so you know what to expect next. Humans have always wondered how the universe started. Physicists have used experiments, observations, and some pretty complicated math to come to the conclusion that at the beginning of time, all of matter and energy burst forth in an event known as the Big Bang. Physics is the study of all this matter and energy and its interactions, from the largest scale, the universe, to the smallest scale and subatomic particles. So what's physics? It's the study of all matter, energy, and its interactions. Let's take a closer and slower look at this definition. Physics studies matter. Here you see oil, an ice cube, water, a beaker, a rock, all matter. Physics studies that. Here you see a representation of energy. Physics studies energy. One way to think about energy is the electrical force that runs through our electrical grid that helps us do work. But it also studies the interaction between matter. So here, for example, we have these metal filings being attracted to the magnet, and it studies the interactions between matter and energy. Let me give you an example. Here's our electrical socket plugging into that electrical grid, taking in energy. That energy comes into our toaster. It heats up our heating elements and it toasts our toast. Thanks, physics. And that is energy, that heat interacting with matter, our toast. Now let's slow down even further and think about each of these categories. Physics studies matter. How do I know if something's matter? We can ask the question, does it take up space? If the answer is yes, then physics studies that. So the sun, this giant ball of nuclear explosions that constantly go on, takes up space. It's matter. Physics studies it. Physics studies things that happen on the everyday scale, like the firing of a cannonball and its path through the air. And physics studies things on the really small scale, like the atom, which is made up of protons, neutrons, and electrons. We can understand that with physics. Physics also studies energy. And how do we know if something's energy? Well, we ask the question, can it do work? If the answer is yes, then that's energy. So, for example, here we see a forklift, and it's moving. Anytime we have something moving, we have the ability to do work. And we call this category of energy kinetic energy. It has to do with motion. So it could be motion in the forward direction where we're carrying that box with our forklift, or even in the upward direction where we lift that box up. So kinetic energy is all about motion. The other sort of energy is potential energy. Potential energy. Here we see a huge pile of water behind this dam, and that's all potential energy. The water's so high up that later on it can do work. That's what potential energy is. It's something that does work later. Notice that that water is pouring out in these waterfalls. As it does that, it turns a turbine that actually produces electrical energy that we can use to, for example, toast things. So potential energy does work later. One other category is chemical potential energy. It's really just a special type of potential energy, but it's one that connects with us very closely because calories measure chemical potential energy. So if I eat that delicious pink frosted donut, I'll get 452 calories and I can go do work with that. Chemical potential energy gives you the ability to work later. When you go for a run, you use chemical potential energy. If you ate that pink donut, you could run like 4 miles. Okay, physics also studies forces. That's really interactions, right? Forces are ways things interact. And when we want to know if something is a force, we ask, does it push or pull? If it pushes or pulls on something, it's a force. Here, our magnetic force pushes and pulls on those magnetic filings. It's a force. Physics studies that. Here, we have the gravitational force. The Earth is pulled towards the Moon and the Moon towards the Earth. That's why the Moon stays in orbit. That's through the gravitational force, the interaction of matter. The atom is held together by the electrical force. The attractive forces between those negative electrons and positive protons hold it together. So physics studies forces. Physics also makes discoveries. So physics makes discoveries. Let's review now three discoveries physics has made. First up, the Big Bang. We mentioned this at the beginning of the video. And this chart is telling us about time as we go forward. And that bright light at the beginning represents the beginning of the universe. How did we figure this out? Well, it started with Albert Einstein. And Albert Einstein proposed the laws of what's called general relativity. And that studied how the universe worked on a large scale. And then later, George Lemaître, who was a Catholic priest, applied these rules to the universe as a whole. And in 1927 proposed that this actually means there is a beginning to the universe called the Big Bang. A pretty cool discovery, if you ask me. But physics doesn't just study the large things, as we mentioned. It discovers things at the small scale. Radiation, for example. Radiation are small little bits of atoms that shoot out at random. And it actually showed that atoms had parts. For a while, people weren't sure if atoms had parts. This discovery was made by Marie Curie. And she found in 1903 that these little particles were popping off atoms. And she won a Nobel Prize for it. She actually won 2 Nobel Prizes. She's pretty talented. Physics doesn't just discover things on the small and large scales, it discovers just practical things, like the laser. And this was discovered by Theodore Maiman in 1960. You see him there in that picture with the very first laser. You also see in the background an awesome laser coming out of a telescope. It turns out that actually we use lasers now to study the stars. Pretty cool stuff. Okay, lastly, let's review our class structure. Here's the way our class will work. A lesson will typically have a video with, say, some practice problems and notes. So you have notes for this lesson right now, and you can fill those in as you listen. Or maybe you'll do an at-home activity. For example, there's one activity coming up where you learn how to drop an egg and try to protect it. That's pretty cool. Also, you'll sometimes do interactive simulations, where you'll work on your computer to play with forces or matter and see how the laws of physics work. What have we learned in this lesson? Well, we've defined physics, we've discussed 3 important physics discoveries, and lastly, we've reviewed our class structure and assignments. Hey!